Choo choo choo. This is a big one! Huh. Whoa! This is a big one! This is a big one! Huh. Whoa! This is a big one! Oh, I could probably fish here.
Hey, Valimar.
Hello, Rean.
I came to see how you're holding up. Sure was a surprise when you offered, but thanks for volunteering to serve as a lookout.
Not a problem. Perhaps you and your friends have influenced me to some degree. Each and every one of you have come a long way to take this place back. I simply wish for you to be able to dedicate this evening to celebrating that achievement.
Thanks. You know, looking back, I never figured the day would come when I'd be able to have a natural conversation with you like this. You've changed a lot in that regard. You've gone from sounding mechanical to dignified, I suppose.
I've been working to gradually recover my memories over time. And while still fragmented, I am now able to recollect specific memories from my past.
Really? Does that mean you remember some of what happened before you went to sleep in the old schoolhouse?
Correct. I went to sleep 250 years, 128 days ago. And my previous awakener was a man known as Dreykul's Rysay Arner.
Wow. So it really was Dreykul's, huh? I had my suspicions when I saw that memory in the last shrine, but I didn't want to assume.
I believe you resonated with the memories that reside within the proving grounds. Dreykul's visited the spirit shrines as you did. In each one, he obtained the same ore with which to forge his weapon, advanced upon the same capital. And it was there, with many allies at his side, that he laid the war to rest in one final confrontation.
It's kind of eerie how similar our paths are, but it makes me feel a little self-conscious too, in a way. I doubt we're doing all this half as well as he did. What kind of person was he, anyway?
He was an open-minded, composed, and driven man. Full of bravery and daring, and in some ways, an enigma. Yet for those he met, he was ever kind and merciful. He had dignity in measure with his stature, and still at times, one could see in his eyes the glimmer of a child's.
He was really something, wasn't he? Hearing you talk about him, I don't know if I could be anything like he was. But maybe if I were, I'd be able to do more for everyone.
There is little need in trying to be something you are not.
Huh?
Since my awakening, I have watched over you. I have seen you grow as a person. Rivals found success in playing to his strengths. You, though different, possess strengths no less great. Just as he attracted his own supporters, so too have you gained those who would choose to stand by your side and no other. Take pride in those who become your sword. For not even he can buy the world to you.
Thanks, Valimar. You're right. I should focus on improving myself as I am, rather than try to become someone I'm not. Seeing as how I'm fighting for my future and to bring home my friend, it wouldn't make sense to be anyone else, really. Oh, yeah. It sounds like the Tachi will be done by morning. So if you're up for it, I think we should test it out tomorrow. I'll be counting on you, Valimar.
I shall do all within my power.
Sorry for the wait, Rean.
Oh, hey, Alisa. I only just got here, actually. All done catching up with the rest of the lacrosse club?
Yeah, it was great to be back with them, but I think we've done enough celebrating for the time being. Plus, Ferris ended up giving me a few friendly words of advice, too. It's kind of hard to say no to a girl who keeps insisting a lady ought to not keep a gentleman waiting, you know?
Yeah, sounds like her all right.
Anyway, never mind her. It really does feel strange to be back here in our old dormitory. In a good way, of course. As soon as I stepped through the doors, all the memories of the times we've spent together here came flooding back.
Yeah, same here. It's been a long time coming, but we finally made it. Well, while we're here, do you want to walk around inside for a bit? I'm curious how things are upstairs, too.
Sure, why not? Time works, isn't it? It's only been a couple months since we were last here, and yet I feel like it's been years.
I guess that just goes to show how much of a mark the time we spent here has left on us, though. Every room, every corridor has a memory attached to it. Just one look, and I suddenly remember it all like it was yesterday.
You know, I guess that's true. I just wish Crow were here with us to share this feeling. It doesn't feel quite right without him.
I wish he were here, too. He's as much a part of Class 7 as the rest of us. Give it time, though. Next thing you know, he'll be right here reminiscing with us.
You really never change, Rean. It was clear from the moment we met. You were someone who really cared for others. And you're as kind now as you were then. You were our leader, always tirelessly looking out for every member of the group and putting our needs before your own. We're so grateful for all you've done, and that goes double for me. Hey, Rean? Do you still remember our first day at the academy?
Our first day? How can I possibly forget? First, we bumped into each other outside the station because I was so taken by the Lino flowers, and then that happened. I'd love to tell you I've done what you asked and forgotten, but that's just plain not possible. Sorry about that.
I should have known. Then again, who am I to talk? It's such an embarrassing memory, I doubt I'll ever be able to forget it. And the part outside the station was the most picture-perfect way to meet you, too. Then we both had to go and ruin it.
I really am sorry about what happened, though. Just so we're clear on that.
In a strange way, though, it kind of worked out for the best. Afterward, I just kept thinking about what happened over and over again. And before I knew it, I couldn't get you out of my head. We barely met. And you were willing to risk getting seriously injured just to protect me from harm. That left a real impression on me. I kept wondering, why? Why would you do that? What kind of person must you be? Next thing I knew, I found myself watching you from afar. I was so curious about every little thing you did. And the more I learned about you, the more I wanted to know. I wanted to find out how you saw the world around you, and how you were able to live so true to yourself.
You know, you were always on my mind, too. You've always been hardworking, with all the pride of a noble and a strong competitive streak. But I think what stood out to me the most was how considerate you are of others, and how you always put them before yourself. All the time you say you were thinking about me, I was probably thinking about you, too. To be honest, you've been on my mind ever since our picture-perfect meeting, as you put it.
Really?
During the past few weeks and months, I've gotten to know more and more about what makes you the person you are. The two of us have had so many long talks about finding our own paths through life, or about deciding how we want to live. And somewhere along the line, I found myself hoping that between whatever you decided and whatever I decided, paths we chose for ourselves would eventually meet and become one, so we could walk side by side.
Does that mean?
I love you, Alisa. And no matter what happens, or what you decide to do with your life, even if our paths one day end up parting and we have to go our separate ways, my feelings for you will never change.
If it weren't for you, I'm not sure I would have ever found the courage to find a path for myself at all. I was only able to because of how much your determination inspired me. How it made me want to struggle on, just like you do. And I love you too, Rean.
I'm so glad. Now, I've got a lot of memories of this place already, but I think this one might leave the strongest impression of all.
So am I. I can't see my face, but I think it's safe to say it's redder than it was at the old schoolhouse. But I'll never forget this moment. No matter what happens, I won't forget. No matter what hardships I might end up facing, I'll just have to think of you, and I'll be strong enough to overcome them.
And the same goes for me, too. I've got no idea if I really deserve someone as good as you. There's still so much I don't know about myself. But I do know that I want you by my side, now and in the future. Whatever may happen, Alisa, I hope we'll be able to find a path we can share with one another.
I hope so, too. Students have gathered.
Understood.
Don't you worry. We'll take good care of them.
Just leave them to us.
Adios and Dreykles the Lionheart be with you all. And please, come back here safe and unharmed. Our objective is to rescue His Majesty the Emperor, as well as those who were captured with him. Everyone, move out!
Right!
do you want to go? Full speed ahead!
Oh, I could probably fish here.
This is a big one!
Thank you. Stay calm. We can get through this. Here I go.
burn to ash! Fall! Now! Let's go, everyone!
Understood!
I'll handle this! Ha!
My turn. Shatter! Now's our chance.
Gotcha! My turn. My blade will cleave ignorance and wipe away.
My turn. Now's our chance. Don't let it pass.
Leave it to me. Pants.
I suppose I should thank you.
Here I go.
Delicious.
My turn. Ha! Now!
An opening! Leave this to me. Shatter!
Right. Hang in there!
You have my
face. I suppose I should thank you.
Very well. Now's our chance. Don't let it pass.
Leave it to me.
Too slow.
Witness the fruits of my training.
My turn.
Let's move. Here goes.
Over.
try!
Let's move! Arcade!
How pathetic.
Huh? Thank goodness!
Exactly how it should be.
A matter of course.
Probably.
This is a big one! Whoa! This is a big one!
Not what I had in mind. Not bad.
Rean, we were just told what's about to happen.
You're to take part in the liberation of the capital, yes? I'm sure you're aware of how dangerous this will be. More so than anything else you've done to date.
I am. But this is our chance to bring the civil war to an end for good. I know how you guys worry about me. But as a student of Thor's, I want to fight to protect my country. And as Elise's brother, I want to fight to take her back. I'm sorry, but my mind's made up. I have to go.
We knew you'd say something like that.
That we did. You're not a child anymore. You've grown into a fine young man. And I have no intentions of stopping you. Do what you feel needs to be done. Bring Elise home and rescue His Majesty, Rean.
I won't let you down.
It's hard to believe just how much you've grown in these past 2 months. I think it may finally be time. You deserve to know the truth, Rean.
Dad?
There's something that I've been keeping from you all this time. I've wondered when this day would come, and now I believe you're old enough and mature enough to handle it. And so, once all of this is over, I will tell you all that I know about your birth.
Darling, are you sure?
I am. I'm sorry for not running this past you first, Lucia. But wouldn't you agree he has the right to know? And I'm sorry to you as well, son. I didn't intend to bring this up so suddenly.
It's all right, Dad. I wasn't expecting you to bring up the issue now. It's somewhere in the back of my mind. I'd always suspected there was something you weren't telling me.
I see.
You did?
It's not like I had proof or anything, but I was found abandoned in a blizzard. Under those circumstances, a kid my age would freeze to death in a matter of hours. And yet, Dad just happened to find me in the nick of time. I couldn't help but wonder if maybe there was more to it. I kept turning it over and over in my head, trying to figure out if there was something I was missing all this time.
I see.
I'm so sorry. We didn't realize you were suffering so much over it.
I don't think it's something you should have to apologize for. I know why you wouldn't tell me. And besides, I feel like I've grown a lot in this last year, too, personally. Thanks to Elise and everyone I've met at Thor's, I can finally feel proud of who I am. And that's why, no matter what happens now, no matter what you have to tell me, I'll always be your son. It's never going to change. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't looking forward to finding out, but it's not the big deal it once was anymore.
Thank you, son.
I was going to do that.
I should be the one thanking the two of you.
I feel like crying.
Your parents are amazing, Rean.
I'm so happy for you, Rean.
Well, guess it's time to go.
Take care, Rean. I know you can do it.
Come back safely, all of you. We'll be right here to welcome you back.
Great!
Yes, you're right. I'm sure he'll be able to handle it.
Indeed. All we can do is believe in him and pray that Adios watches over him from above.
That was unexpected. I didn't think your parents knew who your biological family was, Rean.
From the sound of things, however, they don't know much more than that. You wouldn't happen to remember anything regarding your childhood before being taken in by House Schwarzer, would you?
Unfortunately not. My earliest memory is waking up in this house. I was in bed, and Elise was by my side. Wait, no, that's not my earliest memory. There was something before that.
Okay?
Oh, no, I'm fine. I think we've stayed here long enough. We should probably get moving. Huh? I feel a strange chill coming from somewhere. Is it coming from the valley? Might be good to look into it if we have the time.
To go. Leave it to me.
Thank you.